الريتينال والكرويدل ديزيزز، يعني بشكل اساسي عن الاوتر ريتينال سيركوليشن. هلا راح نحكي عن الريتينال فاسكولار ديزيز، بشكل اساسي عن الانر فاسكولار سيركوليشن. This is also another review للفندس فوتوغراف. الصورة اللي تحت هي عبارة عن الفندسكوبيك فيو from inside the eye. What we see زي ما احنا شايفين في انه هنا الديسك وفي انه central blood vessels coming from it. وهذا distributed into the upper and the lower retinal vessels. والupper بنقسم ل upper temporal و upper nasal، والinferior بنقسم ل inferior temporal و inferior nasal blood vessels. And they are distributed by capillary mechanism all over the inner retina. Again, this is the internal carotid artery. آخر branch منه هو الophthalmic artery. والophthalmic artery هو اللي رح يغذي لنا كل الglobe tissues بشكل أساسي. في عنا الalter circulation اللي هي بتكون من posterior ciliary vessels. وفي عنا central retinal artery اللي هو بيدخل عن طريق الoptic nerve body itself and then redistributed all over the inner retinal circulation. Again, this is just a closer view اللي حكيناه قبل شوي. في عنا إحنا الophthalmic artery بيعطينا central retinal artery، وهو بيدخل عن طريق اللامينيك الكوزن على الاوبتيك نير. وفي عندنا احنا البوستيريور سيلير فيسلز اللي هي راح تغذي الكورويد واللي هي راح تشكل عندنا الاوتر ريتينال سيركوليشن. So again these are the retinal layers. في عندنا احنا هنا الريتينال بيجمنت ابيثيليا لحد ما نوصل للنير فايبر لاير. زي ما حكينا الكورويد بيغذي باي ديفيوجن الاوتر 1 ثيرد اوف ذا ريتينا لحديت اللي هي الاوتر بلكسيفورم لاير، اللي هي اللاير اللي فيها الكونكشنز ما بين السيل بوديز تاعت الفوتو ريسبتورز اند ذا باي بولر سيلز. بينما الانر سيركوليشن اللي هي الاكستنشنز تاعت سنترال ريتينال ارتري اند فين اوكلوجن، دي ويل سبلاي ذا انر تو ثيرز اوف ذا ريتينا باي دايركت كابيلاريز. دايركت كابيلاريز مش باي ديفيوجن. في عنا three main plexuses that supply the retina. بس بشكل أساسي إحنا زي ما نعرف في عندنا إحنا دائما artery، بعدين بنتهي بارتريولز capillary bed، وبعدين تيجي عندنا إحنا فينيول بتكمل، بعدين بترجع عندنا as a venous system. So هذا كله الحكي حكينا مباشرة. شو اللي بيميز اللي blood vessels اللي إحنا عندنا بنشوفهم؟ إنه إحنا we can see them directly. احنا في عندنا transparent retina، فلذلك كثير من diseases اللي احنا might affect the retinal vascular system we can see them sometimes the clinical signs تاعتهم directly without even investigations. طيب what are the signs that might result of a retinal vascular disease? Primarily these signs result from the two main changes in the retinal capillary circulation. Either leakage of these leakage from these capillaries or occlusion of these microcirculation. Leakage, what are inside any blood vessel? Any blood vessel في جواته blood. فالleakage of this blood will cause bleeding or dot or blood hemorrhages. في عندنا plasma inside these blood vessels فالleakage منهم راح يعمل عندنا احنا edema. أو في عندنا lipoproteinaceous material فالleakage from the intra capillary walls will cause depositions of these lipids and lipoproteins مع الماكروفاجز تاعتهم اللي هم راح يشكلوا عندنا الهارد اكسوديتس. الاسكيميا or occlusion of the microcirculation will cause اسكيميا. واحده من الساينز اللي هي الكوتن وول سبوتس، واللي هي الاسكيميا او الانفاركس بتصير بالنيرف فايبر لاير. فبصير في عندنا بيلد اب للاكسوبلازميك فلو بالدبريز بالنيرف فايبر لاير وبتبين عندنا از كوتن وول سبوت. وهلا راح نشوف لهم صور. الكوتن وول سبوتس حتى نشوفهم اكثر شيء كلير عاده بكونوا at the peripapillary area around the area where we have a thick nerve fiber layer حوالين الاوبتيك ديسك. هي الموست كومن اريا ان نشوف فيهم الكوتن وول سبوتس. ischemia also will cause new blood vessel growth. Okay, because the ischemic retina will release a certain vasogenic factors and later on رح نجي لهم more in more details زي vascular network factors which will induce new blood vessels that will grow and it is accompanied by fibrous tissue that will affect any side that they will grow over. إذا زي ما حكينا برضو بالسيمينار اللي قبل شوي these new blood vessels are new blood vessels. They are not real blood vessels. They do not have the full adventitial wall. They are fragile. they are more permeable than intravascular constants and they can bleed easily. طيب diabetes ما حدا يعني بيغيب عن باله انه it's a very very prevalent disease. يعني ان احنا الاردن quite common above 40 عم بحكي عن 30 ل 40% من البوبوليشن هاف سم سورت اوف diabetic diabetic changes. It's the most common cause of blindness in the productive age group, the age ما بين 30 ل 65 year of age. في عنا many يعني خلينا نحكي بشكل اساسي when we are going to screen or to suspect diabetic retinopathy. The type 1 اللي هو insulin independent diabetes mellitus, usually the patients present with symptoms of diabetes. Sometimes the retinal changes or diabetic or ocular diabetic changes اللي ممكن تصير ممكن we have some time lag and sometimes we might these changes ممكن تاخذ 5 years after the onset of type 1 diabetes mellitus حتى نقدر نشوفها. بينما type 2 diabetes mellitus زي ما بتعرفوا او الانسولين independent diabetes mellitus ممكن تكون الديابيتيك ريتينوباثي هي اللي presenting symptom for the diabetic patient for the first time. يعني ممكن يجي المريض ببلورد فيجن او ممكن يجي باكوت لوس اوف فيجن نتيجه بكريس هيمرج وهو ما كان بيعرف من الاصل انه هي اور شي هاز diabetes mellitus. اذا في type 1 usually the onset of diabetic changes a little bit late in comparison to type 2. لما نحكي diabetes احنا دائما نربط diabetes بالdiabetic retinopathy, بس diabetes might cause in addition to diabetic retinopathy also cataract, glaucoma, ocular nervous problems, extramedullary palsy. What are the risk factors for developing diabetic retinopathy? Having the diabetes to start with, the duration of the diabetes mellitus, and after 20 years of incident of diabetes mellitus, almost 80% of the patients will have some stage or some sort of diabetic retinopathy. The diabetic control, the poorer the control, the shorter the period that the patient will start to suffer from the diabetic retinopathy. The coexisting diseases, the hypertension, the hyperlipidemia, كلياتهم ممكن يأثروا على development of diabetic retinopathy. The smoking as a risk factor, family history, and pregnancy, كلياتهم هذول they will accelerate the development of the diabetic retinopathy. The main pathological changes that happens in diabetic retinopathy is the decrease in the number of the vessels which are surrounding the capillaries endothelium. And this will develop what we call in them the microaneurysms from this capillary network, which will allow the plasma and the intravascular constituent to be leaky in the retinal tissue. Also, this will invite the development of arteriovenous shunts between the vein and the arteriolar side of the capillary, which might result from the ischemia and the closure of this intraretinal capillary system. So again, we have hypoxia due to the diabetes mellitus. There are certain factors, hypoxia-inducible factors, في منهم أنواع 1, 2, 3, alpha, beta. This will lead to the production of vascular endothelial growth factors. Even the first, inducing factor للvascular endothelial growth factors اللي هم الhypoxia, الhyperglycemia itself, أو cytokines producing by the inflammation due to diabetes mellitus, أو other growth factors insulin-like growth factor, plasma-like growth factor, كل هذول factors they will invite the production of vascular endothelial growth factor upregulation. وهذا will invite two things, the new vascularization or angiogenesis, واللي هي راح تؤدي الى proliferative diabetic retinopathy, او ممكن تؤدي الى inflammatory process that will interfere with the blood retinal barrier breakdown وتعطينا المايكولر او leakage من capillaries. Again, this is also arteriolar end, venular end, capillary. ممكن يصير في عندنا loss of pericytes ويصير في عندنا leakage, او ممكن يصير في عندنا occlusion ويصير عندنا ischemia. Okay, الاسكيميا زي ما حكينا قبل شوي it will cause production of new blood vessels. هذول new blood vessels they might grow over the retinal surface or they might grow somewhere else, for example over the iris or over the angle of the eye, أو ممكن زي ما حكينا يصير في عندنا leakage of the intravascular constituents. Leakage شوف، في عندنا انترافاسكولارلي، في عندنا بلازما، ممكن يصير في عندنا اديما، ممكن في عندنا لايبوبريتيشس ماتيريال تعمل عندنا الهارد اكزوديتس اراوند ذا اسكيميك اريا من الكابيلاري وولز. بالنسبه للبريزنتنج سيمبتومز اوف دايابيتس، اتس اولويز بيتر that the diabetic retinopathy should be diagnosed before they are symptomatic. هذا شو معناته؟ انه these patients need a regular screening. اذا المريض ما عنده any sign، اللي راح نحكي later on عن signs of diabetic retinopathy، هذول المرضى at least they should have an annual screen for their diabetic retinopathy. بالنسبه لتايب 1 diabetes mellitus او اللي هو الانسولين ديبندنت، ممكن انه احنا يكون معنا شويه lag period حوالي 5 years، زي ما حكينا انه المريض already بيعرف when his or her diabetes has started in comparison to type 2 اللي السكرينينج it should start at the time of diagnosis. بجوز تكون احسن انه all types we need to screen them at the time of diagnosis. Usually the patient might complain about a gradual visual loss, for example in diabetic macular edema. وممكن يصير في عندهم sudden visual loss in the event of a sudden vitreous hemorrhage that happened inside the vitreous cavity. The stages of diabetic retinopathy. The first stage and we have no diabetic retinopathy. وممكن نقسم عدة تقسيمات، لكن احنا هون بالسيمينار راح نعتمد تقسيمة two اللي هما non-proliferative و-proliferative changes in the absence or in the presence of a maculopathy, means the changes that involving the macular area. ممكن نقسم non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy إلى mild, moderate, and severe, and كل واحدة من هذول associated with maculopathy or not. المايلد هلا راح نشوف شو يعني mild. في عنا non-proliferative changes involving one quadrant of the retina. Moderate معناته involving two quadrants of the retina. Severe involving three or four quadrants of the retina. هلا راح نورجيكم كيف بنقسم the quadrants of the retina. هذول طبعا changes كلياتهم الا واحده منهم بنسميها احنا intra retinal microvascular abnormalities اللي هي الايرمز، واللي هي once we detect any one of them in any quadrant we will just move to the severe non proliferative type. In non-proliferative changes that we are examining our patients for are the micro or aneurysms, hard exudates, hemorrhages in the form of dot or blot, intra-retinal hemorrhage, مش vitreous hemorrhage, dot or blot retinal hemorrhages, cotton wool spots, venous changes, and intra-retinal microvascular abnormalities. هاي الصورة. This is a color fundus photograph showing the left eye. زي ما احنا شايفين فيها في عنا هون الاوبتيك ديسك distinct margin. We can differentiate this. The optic nerve has ended here. The retina started here. لكن the striking thing هنا في عنا circle أو circinate دائرة. في برضو دائرة صغيرة circinate صغيرة هون circinate صغيرة هون. فthese are مثلا لما نقارنها مع الدروزنز اللي قلناهم قبل شوي في لها نمط في لها pattern معين around a certain ischemic area. فthis is we call it hard exudate circinate. Hard exudate circinate. This is the first. الإشي الثاني في عنا هنا hemorrhages. في عنا hemorrhages صغار dot hemorrhages وفي عنا large hemorrhages blot hemorrhages. هون إذا بنلاحظ الفين عامل loop inferiorly هون في loop الفين عامل loop inferiorly for this also venous looping. هون في عنا ممكن يكون في عنا هون superiorly في عنا one of the hypertensive changes اللي هي ال venous nipping of the venous system. إذا في هذول changes they are non-proliferative changes. إذا أي change ما فيها new blood vessel growth بنسميها non-proliferative changes. Hemorrhages, hard exudates, hemorrhages ممكن يكون dot or larger blood hemorrhages or venous speeding or looping كلياتهم non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. هاي صورة مرة ثانية برضو showing the right eye color from this photograph. زي ما احنا شايفين the hard exudate they are distributed in a circular manner circinate حوالين ischemic area. وهاي هي الـ OCT الـ ocular coherence tomography showing the intra-retinal cystic edematous changes زي ما شفناهم قبل شوي. وإذا بنلاحظ برضو بالـ OCT في إن هنا whitish lesions عاملات blockage للreflexes of light. These are the hard exudates. These are the hard exudates هون بهاي الصور. الإيرمز زي ما حكينا هم عبارة عن intra-retinal. Intra-retinal يعني جوات الـ retinal surface. They are growing from an artery to vein. They are not over the retinal surface. إذا انتهينا من الـ non-proliferative. The proliferation of diabetic retinopathy معناته بيحولنا للـ proliferative changes or stages. نتيجة زي ما قلنا قبل شوي الإسكيميا, hypoxia-inducible factors, they will invite the growth, the production of vascular-induced growth factors. هذول الـ vascular-induced factor, they will invite new blood vessels to grow over the retinal surface. وهذولا The blood vessels, they might grow over the disc, بنسميهم neovascularization at the disc, or they might grow over the retinal surface, but not near or over the disc, بنسميهم neovascularization elsewhere, or they might grow over the iris, بنسميهم neovascularization over the iris, or أيام زمان كنا نسميهم rubiosus iris. Any of these blood vessels, they are fragile blood vessels, they might cause bleeding. وهذا البليدنج إذا صار بالvitreous cavity بنسميه إحنا vitreous hemorrhage. هاي الصورة, this is a color fundus photograph showing a disc. وزي ما إحنا شايفين, this is a growth of new blood vessels over the retinal surface here, over the disc area. فبنسميها neovascularization at the disc, NVD. هون, new vascularization growth somewhere else also انه في عندنا برضه حوالين الديسك بس هذول اللي بعاد بنسميهم احنا NVEs new vascularization elsewhere. هون ممكن ما نشوف new blood vessel بس ممكن نشوف الريزلتس تاعتها اللي هي الهيمرج. ففي عندنا هنا شيء بنسميه vitreal hemorrhage او vitreous hemorrhage, هذا special type of vitreous hemorrhage بنسميه احنا pre-retinal or subhyaloid hemorrhage, يعني hemorrhage جاي بين الفيتريس والريتنا. So this is also one of the signs of diabetic proliferative diabetic retinopathy. Hi, this is the fluorescein angiogram. زي ما حكينا الفلوريسين is a stain. احنا بنعطيها intravenously وممكن بعدين نشوف where does it stain. Normally we have an intact retinal blood barrier. فالمفروض الفلوريسين ما يصير فيه ليكج في هاي المناطق, بس زي ما احنا شايفين في عندنا هنا very shiny areas due to the fluorescein presence, واللي هي indicates the new vascularization. هذول بنسميهم new vascularization elsewhere. This is the disc, this is the vessels اللي هم central vessels اللي طالعين منه, المفروض تكون intact كلياتها, ما في اي ليكج. Later on these blood vessels they might grow and they will cause contraction or attraction from the vitreous cavity over the retinal surface. زي ما احنا شايفينهم هذول ال whitish lesions هون هم عبارة عن attraction ما بين ال vitreous and the retina, وفي عندنا ال new blood vessels that are growing within these vitreal cavities. For this is proliferative diabetic retinopathy. This is also another picture. هنا أول واحدة فوق على الشمال, wide field view. زي ما احنا شايفين this is the disc وهذول ال attractions. طبعا هذول البلاكش ليجنز هم عبارة عن ليزر ماركس that have been tried for treatment of these diabetic retinopathy. هاي الصورة برضو فندس فلوريسين انجيوغراف showing هذا الفايبروفاسكولار ميمبرين قديش ماخذ ليكج منه من الفلوريسين. This is also تحت هنا اللي هي رقم C في ان OCT picture showing traction. This is thick layers of traction over the retina. وفي ان هنا الريتنا has been detached from the underlying retinal pigment epithelium due to the traction here. This is also another picture. الديسك يا دوب مبين له لونه اصفر هون. فthis is attractional membrane over the retinal surface نتيجة proliferation of the diabetes mellitus changes. الماكيولوباثي, إذا حكينا في عنا proliferative و non-proliferative, وكل واحدة من ال proliferative أو non-proliferative ممكن يكونوا associated مع presence of maculopathy, either presence of the hard exudates or the edema within the macular area. Macula contains the fovea, والفوفيا مسؤولة عن ال high resolution vision, فلذلك it's a vision threatening condition, the presence of maculopathy. وممكن زي ما حكينا تكون مع ال proliferative و non-proliferative changes بالنسبة لل maculopathy. هلا نرجع مرة ثانية إيش قصدنا ب mild و moderate و severe. المقصود فيها إنه إحنا بنقسم بالفندس بخط عمودي, السنتر تاعه بتكون عندنا إحنا اللي هي الفوفيا في خط عمودي, وخط أفقي ثاني بيجي من الديسك also passing in the fovea. وبنشوف هذول الكوادرانس اللي نتجوا عنا قديش هاي changes موجودة في 1 quadrant ولا في 2 quadrants ولا في 3 quadrants أو أكثر, فذلك احنا بنسميهن mild و moderate و severe accordingly. This is also another changes زي ما حكينا these are non-proliferative changes hard exudates within the macular area وجايات زي سيرسنت مانر سيرسنت مانر زي دوائر حوالين الاسكيميك اريا this is also OCT ocular coherence tomography showing the intraretinal edema الريتنا المفروض تكون thin at the area of the fovea مقارنة مع surroundings بس نشوف هنا فين cystic spaces filled with these intraretinal diabetic macular edema treatment or management we have to establish our diagnosis to start with clinically we see what we are seeing and then the ocular coherence tomography and the fluorescein angiography will can be done to assess the degree of ischemia in these patients especially اذا كان في عندنا احنا subclinical diabetic changes ممكن يجي المريض ب blurred vision بس احنا مش شايفين اي clinical signs ممكن نعملهم OCT and fluorescein angiography طبعا المرضى كثير بخافوا من المستشفيات for all these investigations can be done as an outpatient procedures and sometimes the surgery might be needed in very advanced cases diabetic maculopathy or diabetic retinopathy in general treatment now the golden or the mainstay is the injection of antivascular endothelial growth factors في حالات the presence of diabetic macular edema because this will inhibit the production of vascular endothelial growth factors and the accompanying inflammatory process. Steroids also, intravitreal steroids might be tried in certain cases. And sometimes if we have an ischemic areas, we can coagulate, we can ablate the ischemic areas from the outer retina to decrease the production of vascular endothelial growth factor. And this laser, coagulative laser, can be applied either focally to a certain ischemic area within the macular area or it can be applied to the peripheral retina in something we call it pan-retinal photocoagulation. Sometimes if we have severe proliferation and the development of attractional membranes over the retina, there are vitrectomy surgeries, a surgery that we will remove the vitreous body and removing the traction over the retinal surface. So this is the appearance of the retina after doing a laser to the periphery. هذول لونهم whitish هم عبارة عن coagulative scars resulting from the laser. As you can see, we ablate the whole periphery and we just preserve the macular area to have a to preserve the areas that are responsible for the best vision. In addition to the diabetic retinopathy treatment, also the patient do not forget to control his or her blood sugar. Okay, what are the prognosis of these changes will depend on his control of blood sugar, the family history of these patients. If the patient's father did bad, usually also these patients will do also worse with their diabetic retinopathy. Also the stage of diabetic retinopathy, إذا المريض جانا بشوية macular edema مع mild changes, مش زي لما جينا بadvanced proliferative changes. The time of treatment, there is no need to delay, okay? The longer these changes are there, the worse the prognosis. So this is for the diabetic retinopathy treatments. Now we'll go for the arterial occlusion, okay? Arterial occlusion, what can close any wall, any blood vessel can be closed either intravascularly or something within the wall itself of the blood vessel or something around the blood vessel. لما نحكي عن central retinal artery occlusion أو retinal artery occlusion سواء كان retinal أو branch نحكي عن mostly an embolic origin of these occlusive factors. The three main types of emboli ممكن نلاقيهم بالcarotids for example زي fibrin platelet emboli أو ممكن يكون برضو بالcarotids cholesterol emboli أو ممكن يكون من heart valves زي calcific emboli. إذن ففي أن احنا blood vessel will produce an atheroma. هاي الاثيروما will get some of these changes, some of these plaque material occluding our central retinal artery أو ophthalmic artery أو branch من central retinal artery. زي ما حكينا مرة ثانية أي شيء ممكن يسكر الوول إما inside the wall or in the wall itself or the surrounding the wall ممكن يعملنا occlusion. The presentation of the central retinal artery occlusion they usually present with acute loss of vision that is painless. Okay, suddenly the patient will lose his vision. The patient might describe an periods of loss of vision, transient loss of vision that is recovered completely. اللي احنا بنسميه احنا اميروسيس فوجاكس اللي هي زي transient ischemic attacks. وهي ممكن تكون sometimes preceding the full pulmonary picture of the central retinal artery. Sometimes in patients of migraine headache, they might also have the same picture of transient ischemic attacks or amaurosis vojax. ممكن يكون المريض well known to have a heart disease or a carotid disease that will give us a hint that the cause of this is the central retinal artery occlusion. So, هاي الصورة احنا شو شايفين فيها؟ This is also a fundus photograph. بس لأنه نطلع هنا inferiorly, this is the vein اللي هو relatively darker color and this is the artery. في عنا هنا yellowish deposit which is in emboli inside the inferior retinal inferior branch of the central retinal artery. شو ممكن يجي المريض زي ما حكينا symptom wise painless loss of vision acutely. Clinically ممكن نشوف زي ما شايفين هنا في عنا whitening of the retina. Whitening of the retina, but the fovea is not. The fovea is spurred. It is still red in the area, which we call it the cherry red spot. Cherry red spot. The appearance is whitish. The whole retina is whitish, while the fovea is still red. It is a cherry red spot here. Why do we see a cherry red spot? Also, this is another picture showing a emboli here in the superior branch, and you can see that the area here is whitish in comparison to the surrounding retinal, which is, are still red here. طبعاً, this is a fluorescein angiogram showing the delay of fluorescein in this area, which is occluded. ممكن نشوف احنا cherry red spot بالفوفيا فين احنا الفوتوريسبتورز والاكستنشنز تاعتهم لحد ما يوصل للجانجلو سيلز they are laterally displaced. يعني منطقة الفوفيا we need the light to strike directly over the foveal area, فلذلك ما فيها ال overlying layers of the neurosensory retina, فيها فقط ال area of the photoreceptors لحديت ال outer plexiform layer, وهي ال area زي ما حكينا it gets its blood supply usually from the choroid. فاحنا لما نحكي عن central retinal artery occlusion we are talking about the inner circulation اللي هي صار فيها occlusion. فبصير في عندنا edema بالsurroundings هون, edema بالsurroundings هون اللي هي راح تعمل عندنا whitish appearance, بينما الفوفيا will still show the choroidal red color contrast. فاحنا بنسميها cherry red spot. Again, this is also another illustration why we are going to have a cherry red spot here. Okay, فالفوفيا ما فيها layers to be edematous, فهاي المنطقة بتظل clinically color contrast مقارنة مع whitish areas اللي صاروا نتيجة الإديمة. The investigations usually diagnosis is clinical, بس لازم ندور why do we have this occlusion of this blood vessel for underlying factors زي ما رح نحكي بعد later on بالسيمينارات, زي مثلا giant cell arthritis as a cause of this occlusion. The fluorescein angiography might help us sometimes in finding these emboli, and the systemic workup for the cardiac carotid should be assessed, complete blood count, ESR and Doppler carotid should be done for these patients. The treatment, the main aim of treating a central retinal artery occlusion is to try to dislodge these emboli from a central to a more peripheral vessels. يعني في عنا احنا vitreous is pressing over the retinal arteriole. So if we have a way to decrease the pressure of this vitreous body over the retinal blood vessels, we might dislodge these emboli to a peripheral location. But we might try to decrease the intraocular pressure by all means that you know. And especially these attempts should be done if the patient presents to our clinic within the first 24 hours. Usually the retinal tissues have a very short time to bear up the ischemia, not more than 90 minutes. But for medical legal purposes, in the first 24 hours, we should do all our best to decrease the intraocular pressure by using a glaucoma agents, so kind of systematic or topical agents. And the easiest way to do is an ocular massage, what means to practice pressure over the globe. Then sudden release of this pressure, we might help, or we do something we call it anterior chamber paracentesis. The anterior chamber here, area اللي ما بين الايريس and the cornea, and we go on slit lamp or operative room. We might go by a special type of needle just at the limbal area, go inside the anterior chamber, and the pressure will go to zero suddenly. The hyperbaric oxygen also might help in the dislodgement of these emboli. The prognosis. Prognosis of amaurosis vojax is usually with a good outcome because we do not have a permanent retinal or neurological changes. But unfortunately, for the permanent occlusion, the prognosis is really bad. But as early as possible for your presentation, you should consider the management of decreasing the intraocular pressures by all means that we know. This is the arterial occlusion, so I can peripheral or central. Now we'll go for the more common, the venous occlusions. Okay, برضو vein is a blood vessel. ذلك what can occlude this blood vessel? Either something within the blood vessel itself, or the from the wall itself, or the surroundings. So abnormality of the blood itself, as a hyperviscosity syndrome and abnormal coagulation, might predispose this patient to central retinal vein occlusion or abnormal venous wall or inflammation. مريض مثلا عنده uveitis, مريض عندها underlying connective tissue disease, a Behçet disease, they might be associated with perifilibitis. It might be associated مع retinal vein occlusion. أو مريض primary open angle glaucoma that has not been diagnosed. The elevated intraocular pressure might press to the more collapsible walls of the veins and causing usually disturbance of the blood flow within the retina, the venular wall, and causing the atheroma within the venous wall to cause the central or peripheral or branch retinal vein occlusion. Patient also with central retinal vein occlusion, they present with acute, complete, or partial loss of vision depending on the area that has been occluded by the venous system. Usually it is sudden and painless. Sudden and painless avalanche visual vein occlusion. The signs that it might elicit, the visual acuity might be decreased. The anterior segment, it must be important to be examined to rule out the presence of elevated intraocular pressure or to look for signs of uveitis that give us a hint why do these patients have this occluded blood vessel. The fundus, fundus photograph will show diffuse hemorrhages. As we have said, we have arteriolar capillaries, venule. If we have an occlusion of the venular system, we will have a continuous pumping of the blood into the capillaries. This will end up by hemorrhages. The capillaries will rupture all around, and this will give us a flame-shaped diffuse hemorrhages in all quadrants, as we are seeing diffuse hemorrhages. Sometimes الأوكلوجين ممكن يكون branch زي ما احنا شايفين هنا. This is the color fundus photograph of the right eye showing inferior hemibranch or hemibranch venular occlusion. وزي ما احنا شايفين هنا في عندنا hemorrhages flame shaped in the territory of the draining vein. وهنا في عندنا cotton wool spots زي ما حكينا cotton wool spots peripapillary بنشوفهم عادة peripapillary around the optic disc, the area which has the thickest area of the nerve fiber layers. This is fundus fluorescein angiogram also of a vein occlusion, which is central vein occlusion. But what is striking about this picture that the fluorescein is reaching here, but the periphery here is very ischemic. The fluorescein is not reaching these areas. This is an ischemic type of central retinal vein occlusion. هلا رح نيجي لشو أهميته بالبروغنوسيس لcentral retinal vein occlusions. Later on, if these vein occlusions were not diagnosed early, ممكن نلاقي نتيجة الإسكيمة that will result from the vein occlusion. Also, we might see new vascularization elsewhere and new vascularization over the disc or over the iris. Also, we might see it. في طبعا أنواع من central retinal vein occlusion زي ما حكينا في عندنا central, في عندنا peripapillary أو central retinal vein occlusion where is the occlusion just around the optic disc area, أو ممكن يكون عندنا branch. فلذلك ممكن نلاقي عندهم swollen optic disc as a complications. The vein occlusion, they need really a systematic workup. لأنه في عندنا a lot of diseases that might be associated مع central retinal vein occlusion. ممكن نأخذ ال help بعض مرات من rheumatological people to help us in establishing our diagnosis. Diabetes and hypertension also they can cause retinal vein occlusion, so can central أو branch retinal vein occlusion. Fluorescein angiogram, زي ما شفناها, it might help us, especially for showing ischemic areas of the retina, but sometimes in the early phases we might not be able to do it because the fundus is going to be filled with hemorrhages, فماذا يكون fluorescein clear informative. طبعا signs of ischemic retinal vein occlusion هي عادة poor visual visual acuity at presentation and the presence of ischemic areas by fluorescein angiography which might be shown later on. فهذول المرضى اللي بيجوا ischemic type of vein occlusion usually they have a poorer prognosis in comparison to the non-ischemic type. نتيجة ال vein occlusion we will have also accumulation of fluids within the macula, which we call it the macular edema. And this macular edema ممكن تحتاج treatment زيها زي diabetic macular edema. فكل هذول عبارة عن ischemic cases, diabetes, vein occlusion. كل هذول they will lead to ischemia. The cells بخشوا changes نتيجة الهايبوكسيا, بخشوا apoptosis, بخشوا production of vasothermotive factors, زي vasodilatory factors. They will invite blood vessels in addition to the edema formation نتيجة الانفلاميشن. Secondly, إذا صار في إن إحنا ignorance لل central retinal vein occlusion was not managed properly, ممكن صار في إن new vascularization at the disc, ممكن صار في إن at the retina and sometimes at the iris. And this iris will cause occlusion of the angle of the eye between the iris and the cornea will cause something we call it neovascular glaucoma, which usually needs around 3 months to develop. That can somewhat be the 100-day glaucoma. هاي الصورة بتبين في إن الiris طبعا الكورنيا إحنا بنشوف إنها transparent, بس في إن هنا على الiris في إن growth of new blood vessels هذول extending to the periphery of the iris. فit's easily to imagine that this might be associated مع neovascular glaucoma, elevated بال intraocular pressure بالإضافة ل optic nerve changes نتيجة الإسكيميا أو نتيجة عن central retinal vein occlusion. The prognosis of the venular occlusion depends على if it's ischemic or non-ischemic at the presentation. Usually the ischemic has a poorer prognosis in comparison to the non-ischemic type. Well, ischemia usually we assess it by fluorescein angiography later on after the hemorrhages they
الصوت راح دكتور
ما في صوت دكتور
هيك رجع
دكتور بعد اذنك الكريم لا بس ولا شيء اخر دقيقه فقط اخر دقيقه دكتور فقط اخر دقيقه يعني مش كثير
من عند
البروجنوز لا 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 ارجع لا مش من عند البروجنوز امشي شوي لقدام
لانه خلصنا
اللي هي الاثيروسكلروز
يس
ايوه ارتيريوسكلروز
طيب راح نحكي عن الهايبرتنسيف اند ارتيريوسكلروتيك تشينجز ذا مين ستي of or the main effect of high blood pressure over any vessel is to thicken the wall. That means there is sclerosis of these walls. فإحنا the capillaries اللي إحنا بنشوفهم أو الarterioles اللي إحنا بنشوفهم within the retinal body itself or the retinal tissue itself, we can see directly the red blood cells inside them. فإذا صار في عنا أي thickening لهذا الوول بنبطل visibility تبعتنا تكون very clear لهاي الريد بلد سيلز انسايد ذيس ارتريولز فشو بصير في عنا بصير في عندما يصير في عنا ريد كلر ممكن يصير الكلر شوي اغمق تصير نشوفه as a copper wire او ممكن later on يصير الوول very thick انه ما نقدر نشوف اي بلد فيسلز ممكن يصير في عنا silver wiring يعني يصير البلد فيسلز لونهم زي كأنه بنطلع على سلك silver او سلك copper beside ما بنشوف جواتهم بلد فيسلز او ممكن نتيجة the thickening of the wall ان نشوف arteriovenous crossing artery will vein, the arterior will vein within the retinal body itself, they are sharing a common sheath. فلذلك إذا صار في عنا thickening of the arterial wall, it will press against the venular wall وبصير في عنا arteriovenous snipping زي ما رح نشوفهم هلا. طبعا نتيجة الـ blood pressure والـ elevated pressure ممكن يصير في عنا breakage للـ blood retinal barrier ويكون associated مع swollen optic disc أو برضو macular edema نتيجة الـ hypertension يعني بصير في عنا breakage للـ blood retinal barrier leakage of the intravascular constituents within the retinal itself وممكن يصير في عنا إحنا ischemia نتيجة الـ hypertension نشوف cotton wool spots أو نشوف swollen optic disc هنا these are some hypertensive changes اللي احنا ممكن نشوفهم. مثلا بالصورة الأولى هون اللي على اليمين في الـ vessel are attenuated. يدوب شايفين very thin line within the blood vessels of this artery. هون بالصورة اللي على الجنب هون في عنا الـ artery يعني المفروض يكون كلياته regularly red. بس زي ما احنا شايفين النص تبعه بلش يصير whitish. This is copper wiring. هذا لونه زي لون النحاس. It's pressing against the vein. يعني على جهتين الـ artery that's pressing the vein. في عنا nipping من الـ vein من الجهة هاي والجهة هاي. Okay. وفي برضو الصورة هنا في عنا artery that is pressing. فإذا الـ wall of the artery is not completely red. في whitish effect موجود. Inferiorly في عنا نتيجة برضو الإسكيميا بصير في عنا leakage. فبصير في عنا exudation وهذا exudation بيميزه as a star shape شكله زي النجمة around the fovea هون. وفي عنا disc is swollen وفي عنا peripapillary برضو cotton wool spots as a changes that results from uncontrolled hypertension. هاي بس رسمة يعني شو المقصود فيها. البلد فيسلز عادة بكونوا قريبات لبعض باللون. ببلش نشوف الانترافاسكولار كونستيتوينس ببلش اللون تبعها يتحول. اوكي بدل ما يصير رد ممكن يصير في عندنا كبر لونه زي النحاس الاحمر. بعد ذلك ممكن يوصل لمراحل يكون في عندنا سيلفر كومبليت وايتنينج للانترافاسكولار للارتيريال وول. يوجوالي هذول المرضى الهايبرتنسيف تشينجز اللي احنا ممكن نشوفهم بيجوا ببلورد فيجن خصوصا اذا اسوشيتد مع اوبتيك نيرف سويلنج او ماكولر اديما. ممكن يكونوا فيري فيري اسيمتوماتيك يعني المرضى ما يجوش باي سيمتومز ريليتد للريتينال ديزيز. Management, بالنسبة لنا احنا كمانجمنت we need just to have a good control of blood pressure and these retinal changes might take a very long time to resolve or sometimes ممكن يكون unfortunately permanent. شو المهم بالنسبة لنا احنا to advise our patients when they go to their internist to control their blood pressure not to have acute drop in their blood pressure. لأنه retinal cells اتعودت accustomed for a long time on a high blood pressure. فإذا هذول المرضى have an acute drop in their blood pressure unfortunately they might lose their visual functions permanently. فلذلك the reduction in the their systematic blood pressure should be very very gradual in these patients. رح نيجي لإشي quite common إشي بيسموه retinopathy of prematurity اللي هي الROP. There is a failure of normal retinal vascularization which is followed by aggressive new blood vessel formation extending forward into the vitreous which will cause ischemia and complication. هلا احنا ببلش بيدخل عندنا central retinal artery وبعدين ببلش to extend على ال periphery under the effect of hypoxia. احنا في عندنا الفيتل الoxygen tension فيه is lower than normal, lower than our ambient atmosphere. فشو اللي بصير في عندنا احنا ال blood vessels they will grow intraretinally over weeks. هاي الصورة مبينة معنا الجستيشنال ايج مقارنة مع قديش بوصلوا له البلد فيسلز تو ذا بيريفري. فيعني it treats a very long time. It's just at يعني at any time the blood vessels are there under the effect of hypoxia بصير في invitations لهاي البلد فيسلز to grow more peripheral and peripheral to extend. برضو شايفين من الصورة هاي انه النيزل سايد تقريبا على 32 weeks of gestation بكون البلد فيسلز وصلوا له بينما على التمبورال سايد unfortunately يدوب على ال 40 weeks of gestation تكون 38 to 40 weeks بكون وصلوا ال very extensive periphery of the retina. اذا فشو اللي بصير عندنا once انه البيبي انولد prematurely. طبعا في risk factors for developing retinopathy of prematurity في عندنا gestational age كل ما كنا اقل من 32 weeks كل ما كان birth weight 150 or lower. كل هاي risk factors نجمعها مع بعض حتى تعطينا الكرايتيريا for developing retinopathy of prematurity. Exposure to supplemental oxygen, history of sepsis, history of apnea during delivery, the duration of ventilation يعني نحط له tube ولا ما نحط له, اذا في history of blood transfusion, إذا في history of intraventricular hemorrhage, وإذا كان في exposure to light, كل هاي will increase the risk factor for developing retinopathy of prematurity. كل ما كان birth weight أقل, كل ما كانت the chance of developing retinopathy of prematurity higher and higher. Patients اللي بيكون وزنهم أقل من 1500 جرام, usually the chance is around 1/3 to 2/3 of these patients, they will develop some sort of retinopathy of prematurity. Signs will depend على severity ممكن تكون جست اي فاسكولار ريدج، او ممكن يكون عندنا نيو بلاد فيسلز، ممكن نشوف عندنا ريتينال هيمرج، ممكن نشوف ريتينال ديتاتشمنتس او تورتوسيتي او فيتريس هيمرج اكوردنج للستيج. اذا نرجع مره ثانيه، شو اللي بيصير عندنا احنا بيصير عندنا بيريفيرال فاسكولاريزيشن اوف ذا ريتينا نتيجه الهايبوكسيا. هلا الطفل انولد بريماتشورلي، شو معناته؟ بلش يتنفس امبيانت اتموسفير، الاكسجين فيه 21%، فمعناته الريتينال سيلز هذولا رح يعيشوا انه احنا we are not anymore ischemic, they will not produce more vasogenic factors, so the development of blood vessels intraretinally it will be arrested at a certain stage. فبصير في عنا مناطق صارت peripherally non-vascularized، وهذا الحكي بيستمر ل few days لحديت few weeks. After that شو بصير عندنا؟ هذول السيلز ما بيوصلهم blood vessels، بيدخلوا بإسكيميا، وهاي الإسكيميا will produce these vasoformative factors زي ما حكينا، and they will produce they will invite the surrounding blood vessels to grow to the non to the ischemic areas ونخش في proliferation. فالearlier إذا بعرفش إذا أنتوا شايفين بالصور هنا، بس هاي الصور بصير في عنا peripheral area، بصير في عنا بالصورة اللي تحت هنا في عنا الاريا البريفري للاريا اللي وصلوها للبلد فيسلز according to the gestational age بتصير اسكيميك، وهاي الاسكيميا بصير في عنا demarcation line بيميز ما بين الاسكيميك والنون اسكيميك areas، وهاي الاسكيميك areas later on they will produce a vasoformative factors that will invite these blood vessels to grow. يعني كأننا خشينا بإسكيميا and proliferation، وهذا the proliferation of new blood vessels it will just produce a new blood vessels that will contract within the vitreous cavity ويعمل عنا tractional retinal detachment. إذن في البداية بيكون في عنا فقط demarcation line ما بين الإسكيميك والنون-إسكيميك areas، بعدين بصير في عنا ridge in elevated area of the retina indicates the also the demarcation ما بين الإسكيميك والنون-إسكيميك. Later on بصير في عنا new blood vessels that will grow and will cause vitreous traction and retinal detachment. والretinal detachment ممكن يكون total أو ممكن يكون subtotal according to the stage. لذلك بما أن هذول الأطفال فذي we have risk factors, we need to calculate these risk factors gestational age, and accordingly we go for a regular screening for the infants who are at risk. If we detect any changes of the retinal pigment of the retinopathy of prematurity, فيهم برضو كمان criteria when to start the treatment, when to just to follow up, فإذا طبعا according to certain guidelines, according to the area involved, nearness of the optic disc, كل هاي الفاكتورز تدخل when I will go to start the treatment. هلا الإشي المتفق عليه if we reach a threshold stage that we need to treat, okay, we will not go for the details when, we will ablate the ischemic area by laser or by cryotherapy. Okay, if they unfortunately they were neglected for a long time and they developed traction, we need to go also for vitrectomies and to remove these tractions. This is for the retinopathy of prematurity. The importance of it is just for screening, keeping in mind the risk factors. Okay, any ischemic event can lead to ischemia of the retina and to go into the cascade of ischemia. Patients with sickle cell disease also, they have an abnormal red blood cell wall. They might have also peripheral ischemia due to the occlusion of these blood vessels, and they might go to the ischemic events that will ischemic cascade that will lead to the production of new blood vessels and also tractions. It is coming in all patients with sickle cell, especially at risk, especially who are in the crest of the SC alleles. It's very less to have it in the double allele of the sickle cells. Okay, signs usually have tortuous veins due to the ischemia. We'll have hemorrhages, we'll have capillary non-perfusion, we will have salmon colored pigment spots on the periphery of the retina, and later on the new blood vessels also might be developing, leading to a vitreous hemorrhage and a tractional detachment. The treatment or management according to the ischemic areas, we also ablate these ischemic areas. Allah yatikul afi.
أبدع دكتور فواز، شكرا جزيلا، محاضرة جدا قيمة.